Yes, Oni. Please, can you send Emily with my flash drive to the office, please? I have a presentation in 45 minutes, and the presentation is in the flash drive. Please. Let me check. I think it's in the drawer. I left it in the drawer.
Right. Okay, let me check if it's there.
Please do. Don't even make it worse. Don't say if it is there. I know it's there. Please.
Okay.
Oh. So, please, let her bring it as fast as she can, please.
Emily! Emily!
Mom!
Mom! Yeah. Please. Take this flash drive to your dad's office. It has a presentation he is built to deliver in 20 minutes. Did you get that? Check on top of the table. You will see my ATM card. Withdraw 10,000 naira. Take your fare from there and bring back the balance to me.
Mr. Zirim,
sir,
do you realize the enormity of importance attached to that presentation you're built to make this morning?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning.
Good morning. Well, you've greeted me at the boardroom when you asked to be given 10 minutes so that you can round up on your draft and present it to the management before the actual presentation begins.
Yes, sir.
And now I worry. Was this how you earned my father's trust? So that he bestowed this sort of responsibility on you? Is this how you've been doing the job around here? Okay, and is 10 minutes not yet up?
10 minutes is up.
Good luck.
Susan, what's happening now? Why is Emily still not here?
What? She's still not there?
You are asking me. If she was here, would I call you? Would I be calling you if she was here? Eh? Where's this girl, for God's sake?
Just hold on. Let me know what is happening to her.
I should relax. You want to see what is happening with her at this time? What is happening to the two of you? What the hell is wrong with both of you, for Christ's sake?
Emily left since 20 minutes ago.
So where the hell is she?
How the hell am I supposed to know? Just calm down, let me contact her.
I'm calming down. And don't drop that phone. Don't drop that call.
I will.
I'm holding on.
What's wrong with this girl?
Just a minute. Are you there? Okay, just hold on. Come in.
Sir, the MD wants you to come with me immediately.
MD?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell him I'll be with him in a minute.
Okay, sir.
Honey. Susan!
Oh, that's what happened.
friend. I pursued them when they were going. I pursued them to just give me daddy's flash drive. But they snatched my bag and
they did what? You are an idiot. You are a fool. A very big fool. That's what you are. At what age are you losing your back-to-back snatchers? At what age? Talk to me.
They
ran with me. Oh yeah, get out. Get out! Get out. And don't come back if you don't get those items. Not.
You're even asking me why not? How could you be this cruel? Why are you so wicked? How could you? Why would you throw that girl out just because of Mia's stolen items? Huh? Was it entirely her fault?
Oh, it wasn't. Who's then, Frederick?
It was my fault.
Thank God you know.
I forgot that flash drive. Okay, maybe partly hers. But the main fault belongs to you. Because if you were reasonable enough, you would not add banking instructions to a message that urgent and delicate.
Frederick, I wouldn't have you overrun my BP.
Oh, your BP is important to you, and that BP will only not overrun if this nonsense does not repeat itself again in this house.
Oh, who won't say amen to the nonsense of losing money all the time not repeating itself? Or the nonsense of a man setting out to work only for him to forget his tools to come back to haunt me. Amen, Frederick. It better not repeat itself.
Okay. You know what? I'm going out to look for my daughter. And God help you. I find her in one piece.
God help us. God help us.
Oh. Not really. Oh, okay. Have you learned anything with that piano?
Yes, Dad.
Aha. Good. Has any of you seen Auntie Emily?
No, Dad. We haven't seen her since we got back from school.
You haven't seen Auntie Emily in the house since you came back from school, huh?
Yes, Dad.
Okay. All right.
Dad, is she okay?
She's fine. She's fine. I'll be right back. What are you doing here at this time? Huh? Come. Sorry, I found her. I'll call you. Thank you very much. I said come.
I'm going to get angry.
Okay. Daddy's not going to hurt you. Fine, just come. I'm not going to hurt you. You know what time it is?
I'm sorry. They collected the money on the plane.
Was it your fault?
So come. Let's go inside. I won't hurt you. Come.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. I hope they didn't hurt you. Okay, it's okay. Let's go inside. Come on. I'm sure they didn't hurt you. Alright. Jude! What are my things doing outside?
Huh? Hey, you! That's a printer! Why are you throwing it like that? What's going on, Jude?
Is an order from the MD to bring those things in.
An order from the MD?
Yes, sir.
Meaning?
Mr. Ezekiel, good morning.
Morning, sir.
Here. I heard you back. Isn't it obvious to you that for 2 months now that you have been malfunctioning on your duties here, that it wouldn't be long for us to find a replacement? Well, it appears you didn't realize that, but thank God we now have a replacement. This is Mr. Tombra Johnson, am I right, sir?
You're very right, sir.
Good. I'd like you to meet him.
Okay.
Hi. Good. Very good. Well, Mr. Zirim, I'm quite impressed that you have not lost your sense of gentlemanness. Well, you will go from here.
I mean, from picking your things, move
to the personnel department where I'm sure they should have your sack letter ready by now.
Well, it's okay. I thank you for the opportunity of working with.
Thank you too. A little analogy for your interest, Mr. Johnson. Mr. Zirim here was quintessentially resourceful at his prime. But it is very easy to fire around here once you lose your prime. You understand?
Yeah.
And hiring is as easy as you got the job. So, we don't tolerate inefficiency. Once you become inefficient, you get the boot. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let's see the inside of your office.
Yes, sir.
I see you're all packed up to leave now, Mr. Zirim.
Yes, sir.
Then leave.
Sir, I know you're very angry. I know, sir.
You do?
I do, sir.
No, you don't.
I also know the loss this company has suffered as a result of my laxity.
You don't understand. And please don't get me angry by telling me that you understand, because I know you don't understand.
I do, sir. I do.
Mr. Ezirim, if you did, you wouldn't be here. Okay? Especially harboring this asinine feeling that you can come here and talk to me and get me to change my mind. My word, what do you think we are doing here? What? My father suffered his life out to build this place, get it to this position, make it what it is today, a man like you. And all you can do, Mr. Ezirim, is to try and run it down. And you expect me to watch you? Look, I bet you don't think that I'm a fool. I may be young, yes, but I'm not a fool. The only way I think I've acted a bit foolishly was in overrating you, because I thought you were smart. I thought you were smart. If you were smart, you should have seen your sack coming. By the time you started gambling with your jobs around here, you should have seen it coming.
Sir, please. I need this job. Please. I promise you, sir, I can turn things around. I'm just begging. Just give me a second chance. That's what I need, sir. Please, sir.
Okay, that's what you need?
Yes, sir.
It's beautiful. Do you know what I need? Mr. Ezirim, I need you to get up. get the hell out of here. Don't come back. Don't let me shove you. Okay? Because I bet you know that I'm not gentle with my tantrums. It wasn't a pleasure having you around.
The technical partners opted out, so they were no longer interested in our bid, so we ultimately lost the contract.
Did you hear that? You see what you've caused?
Susan, stop! Please stop.
Did you see what you've caused? Eh? I feel like strangling you. You agents of darkness!
I said stop. Stop! Stop! Are you deaf?
I am not!
Emily, you have to stop crying. Okay? Stop.
I'm sorry, Dad.
You do not have to apologize to me. It wasn't your fault.
It was my fault.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was, Dad. If I'd held on to my purse tightly, they wouldn't have collected it. If I'd held it tightly, they wouldn't have snatched it from me.
Fine.
It
was my fault. Fine, fine, fine. But did you know they were robbers? Did you know they were following you? You didn't know. Okay? All right?
Is there no way they can reconsider you? I can talk to the management. Let me beg them. They can reconsider you. That if they have to reconsider your decision, I can beg them. I can go on my knees and beg them.
They won't.
Oh, God. This is not fair. This is not fair. This is not fair. They're daddy. I can explain to them. I can explain what happened to them. I'm sure they'll call
Stop
you
crying,
back.
Okay? Stop.
No, daddy, let me beg them.
Okay. I have begged them. I have appealed to them. I've made all kinds of entreaties to them. They will not listen. So there is nothing we can do about it for now, but just to adhere strictly to what the Bible says about this, which is that the latter part of our splendor will be greater than the former. Okay? So stop crying, baby. Come on, come on, come on, it's okay. Daddy's gonna bounce back again, okay? No? Don't cry, okay?
Okay. Emily. When do you intend to finish up the laundry I said for you?
It was only when Daddy got back.
Daddy rightly said. Now, disengage from him, go finish up your chores before I pour the full weight of my wrath on you. Bad luck.
What was that about? Daddy, you rightly said, and all that. Terrible out there. Very terrible. Very, very terrible. Too many passengers chasing the very few buses that, you know, we have around there. And then it's a whole thug of war getting into the buses at all. So it's terrible. So how are you kids?
Fine.
So you've had your food, you've all eaten. Have you eaten?
Yes, Dad.
Harold, have you eaten?
Yes,
sir. All right. That's good. Where is Emily?
In her room, Bab.
Oh, in her room. Ah, okay, I hope she's fine.
Fred.
Yes, sir.
Welcome. Learn how to worry less and pay more attention to things that matter.
What are you talking about? Are you telling me that the well-being of our daughter is not important? Is that what you're trying to tell
me? I haven't said that. I am pressed because we have more disturbing things around, other than the well-being of a well-grown-up girl.
Okay. More disturbing things around. All right. Tell me about these more disturbing things around.
Well, since you have refused to relax, the landlord's lawyer sent you a delegation here today. That's the letter on the table. Harriet, go get that letter.
It's not a letter, I don't can bring this.
Come up, I'm bring it. Stop shifting the box to me.
Can't bring the letter, sir. Can't you have some?
You and I, who is more helpful to your dad?
Stop. Shut up.
What is that? Oh, somebody should go and give that letter to your dad. I said somebody should go and get that letter. Is that? Is he mom? Dad, are you sleeping?
Well, not really. I'm still awake.
What is it?
I went to the Cyber Cafe to check my admission status. I was going to tell you, but you said you were busy.
Just as I still am right now.
Hey. My darling. You said you went to the Cyber Cafe. What happened?
It's no news telling us you've been admitted into the university. We are into the third best student in JAMB and the second best in post-JAMB screening.
Thank you, Mom.
Are you telling me that you've been admitted?
Yes.
Into the university?
Yes, daddy.
Come on,
sweetheart. Shush, shush, shush. Where are you going to? What are you feeling like? Huh? Come on, get out. Who doesn't know what brilliant brain you're made of? Just don't let it get into your head.
It won't, Mom. Good night, Mom. And good night, Dad.
Good night, darling. Susan, were you actually breathing now, or you were just jealous?
Whatever.
You're back from school.
Yes.
Okay, how was your day at school?
It was fine.
Good, 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 huh?
Yes.
Okay, now you know what you're gonna do? You'll all go to the kitchen, have your meal, and wait for that.
Okay?
Daddy's going out for an appointment.
Daddy, I go to my room.
No, Daddy will be back very soon. Any problem?
Yes, Dad. Our teacher has divided us for our office.
We are the only one
who has not paid in our class.
School fees. Huh? See, Daddy knows he has not paid your school fees. Daddy knows, and Daddy will pay your school fees. Huh? That's why Daddy is going out now. When Daddy comes back, he's going to pay your school fees. Huh?
Okay,
all right. So you're going to go in, huh? And have your meal, okay? Mommy's not around, so don't spoil or scatter anything in Mommy's kitchen, okay? All right, sweetheart. Daddy will soon be back, okay? Don't spoil Mommy's kitchen, no. All right? Okay? Daddy will be back soon.
Fantasize of him being romantic, very attractive, or sexy.
Mom!
What? He's my father. We have an understanding on that. That is why I said, supposing he is not.
Mom, please, can we discuss something else?
Like what?
Like my admission. My mates are registering. So what are we going to do? Their exam is a matter of days.
I don't know. You know, these are very trying times. It's weighing me down. You know, I'm trying to see how best I can shuffle things around here to accommodate our financial obligations, school fees, rent, and now Emily's enrollment fees and all of that.
So what are we going to do about it?
I don't know. But I've been thinking about withdrawing Harold and Harry. This is a very expensive private school, you know. I'm putting them in public school. Because this year, 340,000 school fees. Now, if we had that money now, it would go a long way. Funny thing is, I don't even have it.
Withdrawing my children from school?
Why do you read things from the opposite? Huh? Am I dumb? Huh? Why would I want to withdraw my own kids and put them
in? Tell me what you want to do.
I'm just saying that. Okay. I just was like looking at the possibility of taking them away from this expensive school and putting them in even this unity school, you know, St. Teresa.
That will not happen, Fred.
So what will happen? Huh? What will happen? Well, I don't even, do you know, I'm not even going to conjecture this. If I had the money, what would I withdraw my kids from that good school and put them in a public school? Huh? We don't even have anything. The little we have cannot even contain anything.
Don't worry. I will take care of my children's school fees. You run around and take care of the rest. What?
You take care of it. Okay then. Okay. That means I would just hold the landlord off for a couple of months until my payoff is ready. Thank you.
You don't have to thank me. They are my children.
They are your children. Well, then I don't want to put them down.
Excuse me.
Huh? She loves all over your face.
Excuse me.
Why did you?
Please go to bed.
Let's sit down. Come, woman, stop pretending. Thank you, darling. Just so sweet.
Have a good day.
Thank you, Mom. But you haven't given me the money.
What money?
I'm going for my registration, Mom. And Dad said he had discussed with you. So you give me the money.
How am I supposed to give you the money? What do I look like? A bank? The bank?
Excuse me, sir.
Waiting.
You know, sir, that today is the 26th of this month.
I know.
And you know, pay me for last month.
I know.
I get a message from village. Say my first wife went there for village. He there for hospital. And my second wife, we get belle, the one born. Please, sir. Oga, I need some money, please.
What you gonna do? I know, sir, they owe you. Yeah? I know, sir, I never give you money 2 months now.
Yes, sir.
Now, small thing will just happen. After everything go clear.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
I go give you money. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
I go, just cool down small for me. Make you call them, say after you go send message, to them. Yeah? Okay, may I just go down here?
Please, Oga. Oga, please. I need that money, please.
Chinedu, now me tell you now, say I know say I never pay you 2 months now. I go give you. Now small thing where they happen, no. Not be saying a big problem. It don't happen like this before.
No, sir.
You go cool down small now. I beg. I go give you. Yes, yeah? Yes, no worry. Go. I go give you.
Thank
go.
You, sir. Thank you, sir.
Emily.
Yes, Abby.
Are you okay? Jesus. Are you okay? You're back from the campus. Are you okay? Oh. I am not mistaken. That's not what you told me.
I told you I was going to cater for my children's school fees, of which Emily is not one. Well, let me put it more politely, it's no longer one.
What did you just say?
I can bet my life you heard me, Frederick.
Why are you so wicked? Why are you so cruel from the bottom of your heart? Why are you so wicked? You open your mouth and you say... Bestially cruel woman. Let this be the first and the last.
No, it won't be the last.
When I am talking, you listen.
You listen to me this time around, Frederick.
Okay.
We have done our best for that girl. I have continued to love and see her as my child, but I'm not breaking it.
Try harder.
No.
I said try
I
harder.
I said no. We are talking about maternal love here. Not some scripted melodramatic show-off of love or affection. Eh? I can no longer bear it. Pretending she's my daughter when I know she's not. Or that I love her when I know I do not.
But Susan, do you know that this girl was the first to bring us the joy of parenthood? This girl taught us how to love a child. And how a child should love the parents. Are you going to wash all of this and throw it away? Just like that? Susan?
Frederick, truth crushed to earth does always rise again. Let us see this as the moment of truth with that girl's life and face it.
Okay. But we'll face it. You know what? If it has to do with her enrollment fees at the university that is causing all of this nonsense, don't worry. I will take care of it.
Indeed.
Emily? 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 Emily?
Emily? Emily!
I'm here, Dad.
Well, obviously, Mommy doesn't have the kind of money you need for your school enrollment, at least for now. But I will take care of it. You don't have to worry at all. I will take care of it.
How? How will you take care of it, Daddy?
See, Dad is a man. Daddy has friends. I will call my friends and they will help me, okay? So don't you worry at all.
I want to ask you a question.
Okay, what is it?
Will you tell me the truth?
What is it? I mean, what can...
Emily!
Yes, Mom?
What are you doing there?
Nothing.
To the kitchen. Lunch time is up.
What's that look for? Is there something you're trying to say with that look on your face?
None that I remember. Unless there is something you are trying to tell me by those your hugs and cuddles with her. The LCM has been clearly defined. Emily is not our daughter. Cut down the rate at which you fraternize with her.
But you know what?
You tell me.
I think you're insane.
Really? I would think so too. If I'm the one being told to my face to stop playing with an impostor of a girl. Young lady, I shouldn't be the one to tell you the things ordinarily you are supposed to have decoded since a couple of years now. But if you pretend not to read the handwriting on the wall, I will also pretend not to be writing on the wall for you. In the meantime, stay away from my husband. Not your father, this time around. My husband.
Mother. Can you at least tell me who my real parents are? Please.
Your parents. I doubt if any human being would know that. The most probable people to know are the trees and grasses around the area where your savage mother abandoned you.
Thank you.
What can we possibly be here tonight? Huh? What is it again this night? This whole house, you alone, pacing around. Huh?
I remember telling you, as a matter of fact, promising you that I would personally take care of all of this. Or is it that you don't believe Daddy anymore, my love?
I do, Daddy. It's not about you.
Okay, it's not about me. I know it's about your school registration money, enrollment stuff and all that. Okay, why don't you give Daddy between now and tomorrow? I will personally make sure that you are enrolled, you are taken in, and then you start your classes with everybody, okay?
That's just about enough, Fred. Emily, go to bed.
Hey, come back here!
I said now!
I said stay here now! You listen, okay? This is getting out of proportion. And I'm not going to take it anymore. The attitude you've been giving me in this house, I will not take it again. No, listen, please.
No. Is that not what you want?
I should go to bed. I'm sorry.
You should be. Because I gave you life. So you don't dare take mine from me.
Absolutely. No, we have not received it.
Yeah, but I believe in due time we'll receive it.
Yeah, I assure you. Well, you have a nice one. And thank you for calling.
Yeah. Mr. Izirim.
Yes, sir.
The accountant told me that you came again for your payoff.
Rightly so, sir.
Well, it's unfortunate that we cannot pay within this time.
Sir, please. Excuse me, please. I'm begging you. I know how bad things can get when you're not happy. But again, I appeal to you, sir. Sign this payoff for me. Please. It's a matter of life and death. Please.
Are you threatening me, Mr. Izirim?
I mean, could I possibly threaten my boss?
Ex-boss.
Whatever, sir, but I'm just begging you, sir, to see reasons with my predicament.
Please, your predicament matters nothing to me. You inflicted it on yourself, so why should I care?
Well, you have every right to think so, sir.
Yes, I do, and I am choosing to think so. Besides that, the legal time frame within which we are supposed to remit your payoff is 6 months. And you and I know that it has not elapsed. So I will advise that in the meantime, you go home, readjust to your present economic situations, and try not to further disturb us. Because we too have our own economic situations, large chunk of economic situations for that matter, and predicaments also to deal with. No thanks to your inefficiencies while here.
Sir, please.
Mr. Izirim.
Sir, I am begging you.
And I am thanking you for coming. So, please. Thank you.
there, please. Get me some water. Emily. Emily. Emily.
You're back.
Yes, I'm back.
Welcome.
And where is Emily?
Where is Emily? Probably in her room or somewhere around. Any problem?
No problem.
Okay. Daddy. I've addressed this letter to you because I know you're the only one who would care to look for me. But don't worry, because I'm gone, never to come back. I've been in the dark, why I must always be treated like a slave by everyone except you. But my eavesdrop to your argument with Mommy some days back threw a lot of light to my darkness. I'm sorry to have eavesdropped. But I thank God I did, because it has helped me to make this decision today. I thank you for all your fatherly love and care to me, even amidst all the pressures and accusations against it. I know you'll be worried and may want to look for me. But no, do not waste your efforts, because you'll never find me. And even if you do, I'll never come back to your house. Thank Mommy for me. Tell her that her attitude towards me has also helped me to take this decision, while her candid revelations will guide me throughout my life. You are the best father any child could ever have. I'm sorry about the job, Daddy. I'll keep praying for God to grant you a good one. My regards to your son and daughter, Arnold and Harriet. Bye.
What letter is that?
What did you tell her?
What did I tell whom?
Answer my question. You wicked woman, what did you tell Emily?
Oh, that? Frederick, please.
Don't you fucking Frederick please me! Don't patronize me. I want to know what you told Emily. What did you tell Emily?
What could it possibly be other than the truth?
Oh, the truth.
Yes.
The truth, okay. Now you tell me the truth. Tell me the truth. Tell me the nonsense truth, you witch!
Did you just call me a witch?
Yes. You couldn't give me a baby because of what you did in the past. Why? You were busy committing abortion.
Frederick!
Will you shut up? Until we were able to bring in that young...
Frederick! You are not in any position to tell me that rubbish! You and I lived and could not have a child because you and I were sterile!
No. You were sterile.
You were sterile, Frederick! Did you conceive? Or did you get someone pregnant within those 12 years? Answer me! How am I even sure this whole damn thing is not your fault after all? Now you better stop crying over spilled milk. Emily is gone and gone for good. Her cleavage is currently out of your lustfulness coverage area. Nonsense. Rubbish. You know too well not to try. Oh yeah, slap me! Nonsense.
So, I don't know, what would you want? You wanna take your bath? Okay, just come. Let me take you. Let me show you to your room. So you're free to stay here until you get well enough to... I'm sorry. Where did you say you're going to? What were you running from? Tell me, what is it? You know, you almost jumped into my car. Love it. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Maybe this is not the best time to ask you all these questions. It's all right. So... would you want something to eat so you can take the drugs? Let me go fix something for you. I'm going to be back shortly. Please, excuse me, I'll be back shortly, okay? Yes.
We agreed, but you never showed up. No text message, no call, or even a flash to explain yourself. What is wrong with you, Carl? I asked again.
I'm sorry. I had a delay. So I felt I'm going to explain everything to you when I'd seen you, okay?
Naughty boy. When we see, huh? So why not start now to give me the explanation? Starting right here.
Annabelle, please wait. When are we going to stop this?
I've never considered stopping it, so why do you ask?
You've never considered stopping it?
Yes.
What if Jane finds out?
For Christ's sake, Carl, Jane is my best friend, and she trusts me with her life.
Which is the reason why we need to stop.
Cut this crap, Carl. You and I know that you don't have a conscience when it comes to a woman's gut. So, why not stop all this moral lessons and start giving me some action?
Mother, please.
Is there any problem?
Yes, and that is you and I cheating on my fiancé, which I'm no longer comfortable with.
Since when?
Since whenever.
Carl, what is happening? What's this blood I'm seeing?
Oh, I had a cut, yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Baby. Oh, Oh God, I'm so sorry. Now I know why you've been tensed up all this while. Why can't I help
you? No, it's okay. Don't worry. Just thank you. I'm going to get it disinfected and dressed shortly, okay?
You're going to get it disinfected and dressed shortly?
Yeah.
But that means you have not dressed it yet. And come, but you're not bleeding now.
Annabelle, you know what? You need to get going. Now, like right now, okay? Come. Please, just leave.
I
beg of you. Do you understand? Please leave. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Thanks. No, please. Thank you so much.
Come,
please. No, please leave.
Wait, I'm going.
Thank you. You can go. Thank you. That's the door. Thanks a lot. Please go, okay? Thank you. Gonna go?
Yes, Alan, I'm going.
Anything for the boys?
Let me find something for you.
Before the birth of my siblings. When? Sorry. They are kids. When the woman changed towards me. At first I thought it was part of the changes that pregnant women undergo. But it continued and got to its height recently when my dad lost his job. Her husband, the man I thought was my father.
You can still go ahead and call him by what you used to.
No. I want to detach myself from them all.
It's okay. So what transpired?
I lost his job. And that became the turning point. I had the best SSC result in my school. Best overall GEM result. And third best student in my post-GEM exams.
Whoa, you're such a brain. Someone like you should be given the best support.
You think so? But the woman I knew as my mother didn't think so. She instantly saw me as a threat. Everything I said or did irritated her. If it were for my dad, the man I thought was my father, I'm certain if things were well with him, he'd see me through my university education.
So what happened? She refused sponsoring your education?
Not just that. She wanted me out of her home. She was tired of pretending like she liked me when she didn't.
Mm. bastard is not even picking his phone.
Worst of all, she thought I'll take her husband from her.
What rubbish. How could she insinuate something like this? This is someone you know and see as a father.
That's it. That's it. I decided to forge ahead with my life. She said they picked me from a ditch. I don't even know how to search for my parents.
What is wrong with him? Why is he acting funny?
It's alright, okay? Please stop the tears. I beg of you, stop it, okay? It's okay.
He's not even picking my coats. I think I should find out what is wrong with him. I think he could. God should help both of us. Why do you don't be that he has found another girl? Because girl.
So Carl, you mean the girl ran into your car?
Yeah, literally. Yeah.
I mean like suicide attempt or something.
Well, I talked to her at first. But after she had explained herself to me and we talked about everything, you know, I didn't understand she was merely traumatized.
And you took her to the hospital. Is it where she is now?
Well, she's with me at home.
Excuse me?
Then look, the girl needs help. You know, she has lived with a foster family who now turn against her because they have their own kids. And besides, she's cold-headed and her story is quite touching, my brother.
Oh, you okay? Okay, Carl. You want to tell me you're touched?
Hey, you needed to hear this girl's story.
Oh, come off it. Sincerely, if I have my wedding coming up in 3 months' time, I wouldn't want to hear any girl's story to the point that you're putting up with her under the same roof. Come on, guy, what are you thinking?
Look, man, I'm a Christian, okay? Whatsoever you do to the least of your brother, Christ say that you've done it to him, okay?
Why not save this summer for Jenny? Because she's the one you'll be getting married to, not me. Am I the one who's talking about Christianity? You, Carl.
Are you trying to say that I'm not a good Christian or what?
I'd rather not say that all. Because God knows it all. It's cool, man. It's cool. It's cool, man.
What now? You know they. You know Colum?
No. But I don't come. What have you noticed that been going on with your guys since yesterday?
Yesterday?
Yes.
He
has been acting so funny since yesterday.
Tiany. How do you know that one now? You know, because I be how good that one.
But come, I saw some drop of blood in the house yesterday. Did he get into any fight with anybody?
Oh, The blood?
Yes, the blood.
I saw it. But no. Let me go wound. Let me go. I won't get away this wound.
A girl? Inside where?
The house.
You mean a girl is inside our house? Thank you. Let me go inside and wait for you, okay?
Okay.
Does this money look good to you? By the way, who are you and what gave you the guts to flirt with a man to the point of moving in your tents?
No, it's not true. None of that is true.
Oh, shut up! What is not true? The flirting part or the moving in part? Listen, let me tell you something. I don't even like you looking into my face to call me a liar. Do you know the worst part? You so much disgust me.
Did anybody ask after me? Auntie Arabe.
Auntie who?
I thought about your girlfriend, Naga. Your girlfriend first.
So this idiot too has decoded there's something going on between Annabelle and I. God help me, let's Gemma find out.
Even with your luggage, are you planning on living here or something?
No, I just...
Annabelle!
Oh, thank God! Carl, who is this thing and what is she doing here?
The most suitable question here is, what are you doing here? Now answer me!
Wait, Carl. Are you asking me what I'm doing in my best friend, prospective matrimonial home?
Which is of nasty my home! Annabelle, how dare you barge in here and begin to harass my guest? Are you insane?
I should be asking you that question, Carl. Since you didn't realize that you're going to be getting married in next 3 months, you still have the guts to house a tart. A street tart for crying out loud.
I'm not a tart.
Will you shut up?
Annabelle! Ah! What is wrong with you? You know what? Get out of here.
I beg your pardon?
You will not have my pardon. Because you've really stepped out of the line. Now, get out. I said leave.
Carl?
Don't let me show you.
You're asking me to leave.
I'm telling you to leave this moment. And next time you want to come, make sure you get appointment. Leave.
Yeah, I'm so sorry about all this, okay? I'm sorry, it's okay. Sorry, she has no right whatsoever to have spoken of you that manner. Okay, I'm sorry.
Is that who you told them I am?
God forbid. I haven't discussed you with anybody. You know what? Excuse me a minute.
Let it go.
How could you allow a stranger into my house in my absence, Aaron?
Huh? Stranger? Okay. Maybe I'm gonna follow come back here yesterday.
Are you mad?
Never start, Oga.
I'm talking about Annabelle, and you're talking nonsense.
But Oga, I tell you, I'm a stranger now. That be the same person when they come here, when they sleep, even the time where Auntie Jen know they're here. She they cook for you, they wash for you.
Will you shut up?
Sorry, Oga.
But I hope this is not what you're about to be.
Me and person no fit discuss about those now. But Oga, I still wait to talk to you anytime where she come here. Make a letter mean. Eh? Prof say Auntie Jen know the house.
My friend, I know what I told you. And I'm telling you again that anytime she comes here, except to get permission from me, don't let her into this compound. Do you understand?
Oga, until now.
Are you mad? Unless I authorize you, don't ever let her inside this compound again. Is that clear? Why are you moving your luggage?
It's obvious my presence is causing you problems.
Hey, look, it's okay, right? This is my house, and as of today, I live alone. So don't mind that silly girl and all the nonsense she was blabbing about. Disregard her, okay?
I don't want to cause you any problem.
You're not causing me any problem. I'm the one who decided you can stay. No other person except me has the right to ask you, okay? So please, come on, move your things right back into the room.
Thank you.
Please. Love it. Have you had something to eat?
Yes, Janet. I know exactly what I'm talking about. I saw this pretty young girl in your prospective matrimonial home with your prospective husband. That's what I'm talking about. When I don't understand, there is nothing I can do to calm in his house. The only thing I can do is what I am doing right now by calling you on phone, Janet. So you better take some time off that your banking job and come down here. Let's face this out. Of course. Better.
When I was just 10 years of age, our parents had died, and we were staying over at our uncle's. Over there, life was not the same the way it was with our uncle, with our parents. My elder sister was 12, and she was always at the wrong with our uncle's wife's order. I know she does her best, but maybe her best wasn't good enough for her. Our uncle barely stays at home. So that fateful night, she was asked to carry her bag and leave.
Why?
Maybe because of a broken plate or cup. I can't remember. I wept the much I could. I never wanted her to go. I would have gone with her, but no. The woman would not want me to do any of the two. I can't say. She looked at me. I don't know if she was angry at me or disappointed that I didn't go with her. I just can't say. And that's the part that maddens me. That look, that glance, was it a glare?
You could have asked her. Why didn't you go with her?
I didn't go with her. I could have asked her if only I've seen her again after that night.
What happened? You didn't see her again?
I didn't see her again. Because love had died. She died a very painful and helpless death.
No, please, sir. Perhaps you shouldn't be talking about this.
I should tell you, so that you can know why I have to go all the way to keep you safe. Juliet, my sister, was gang-raped that night and killed by unknown miscreants.
Please, sir, stop.
No, please, love it. I need to get this out of my chest. I need to tell you this. Because I've been feeling guilty all my life. I've been feeling guilty. I don't know, I feel I didn't do enough to prevent her from dying. You know, I would have made her not to go out that night, you know.
You said you were 10. There was nothing you could have done.
Maybe. And maybe if I stood up against my aunt and told my uncle the truth of what happened, how so would have gotten more reprieve? I can imagine how bad she felt being lied against. Because my aunt lied against her. She lied at my sister Juliet, having keeping late nights and flirting around with boys. And as she got up that night after she had chastised her for the broken item and said she was tired of staying, that was what my aunt lied to my uncle that happened.
I'm sorry, sir.
All right, love it.
Sir. My name is Emily, not Lovett. I didn't know you well enough. I didn't have the confidence to tell you my real name. I'm sorry I lied.
It's okay. I understand. Emily, I want you to be very careful. And I want you to always remember the story. And please, try and stay away from anywhere that could make you vulnerable. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Correct.
What? Here we are. Do not say a word, darling. It was meant to be a surprise.
Baby.
So how is my baby doing?
I'm splendid. What's with this calling? I hope everything is okay.
Everything is perfect with me, but I was wondering if the same applies to you.
Oh, yes, certainly. I'm good. My word, okay. You didn't even give any notice.
Come on, darling. Notice? Don't give me reasons to start suspecting you. Notice in my house. I hope you're not hiding anyone here, somebody, somewhere here in this house. I think I need to check that.
Whoa. Come back here.
What?
You're falling out again. Tell me, when was the last time you kissed me? 1 month ago? 2 months?
Like a moment ago.
Yes, I can see that. A moment ago.
Okay, fine. It's time for a walk.
Walk. I should go to walk. In my bedroom, and of course, what's your mother?
Good morning. Sorry.
Who is she?
I can explain.
Does she live here?
Please calm down.
Answer me! Does she live here? I'm still waiting for your answer. Does she live here?
Yes. She lives here temporarily.
Nonsense. Nonsense! She's leaving. Right now.
Come back. Are you going to disregard the fact that you just slapped me?
Leave me. You're hurting me. Leave me alone.
Please, Janet. Please. For as long as we've been married, and until death, no matter how high your anger gets, please, I beg of you, don't you ever raise your hand against me. Do you hear me?
Don't you ever hear me? Yes! Yes!
Now sit down and let me tell you who she is. Sit down and let me tell you who she is.
I don't want to listen to anything you want to say. Interested in your greetings or whatsoever you want to say. All I want from you, get dressed, pack your things, and get the hell away from my home. Do you understand me?
Robert, wait. Emily, baby, can we talk?
No, we can't talk. You have nothing to say.
Baby, I have a lot of things to say.
No, you should have called me to explain whatever you have to say, not to wait for me until I get back here to bust your ass before you are explaining. Young girl, are you done packing?
Okay.
Keep moving!
Love it, she has nowhere to go.
No, I don't care. My matrimonial home is not a home for the homeless. Do you understand? Are you done packing?
I'm packing.
Aaron, what is the meaning of this? Is it because of the 500 and the 1,000 naira note I give to you that is giving you effort to insult me this way?
Atalabe, you never even give me the 1,000 naira self if that one. But that one will be the problem self. Nah, the order will give me, that me I carry.
Let me ask you the question. Who gave you this stupid order?
Now whose order will me I go follow before uncle? Eh? Maybe the order of the stupid person. Hey, sorry. The other guy will beg your house. Now go follow.
Done a minute. Sweetheart, Annabelle has been stored outside by Aaron, who said you ordered him to do so.
I gave him the order.
Would you mind terribly if I asked why?
Yes, I would.
Don't walk out of the Callistos. Don't dare walk out on me.
Tell me what to do. Who do you think you are? What do you think you're doing? Running me? Hell no. You can't run me. My order is that your friend Annabelle...
My best
talk the best. I said that she's not the weapon into this house. My order is fine.
Why? I ask you why.
It is not open to deliberations.
Oh, because she caught you?
Because she saw you with that thing, that girl. Hold on a minute. Where's that girl?
Hello? Hello, Jane. Yes, I'm still out here, you know. Look. This is unbearably humiliating, you know. How can you just be in there and allow him to still keep me out here for nothing? Okay, fine.
Move it. Keep moving. Go, go. Keep moving. It wasn't nice having you around here. Just go. Go, keep going.
Hold on a moment. Emily. You know what I can tell you? Life could be this tough. And even tougher. But always, the tough gets going. I bet you now agree with me. If anyone says the world would have been a better place without women.
I beg your pardon, Cap.
Please, I'm not talking to you. Do not interrupt me. Do you understand? Emily, if you ask me, I'll say you move on with your life. Don't go back to your past. No matter how hard and difficult it seems to be. And please, do not allow your tough past pull you down. The memories of it drag you down. Don't allow that, okay? This is a check. Take it. It should be enough to start you up in school. But if it's not enough, see what you can do. And please, always remember about Juliet. And try to be safe, okay?
Okay. I will. Thank you, sir. Thank you, auntie. Don't even try making me feel guilty. Do you understand? You have to leave this house and you're leaving right now. So keep going. Keep your thanks to yourself. Keep moving. Move. Just go. Keep moving.
Lunch is served. Then, please come to
me. I'm not eating.
What did you say? You're not eating. Why? Because of that girl, that thing?
Yes, Janet, because of that girl. I'm paying because you denied me the chance of mocking the beast that took away my sister's life. They gang raped and killed her. They failed so much of men, but I wanted to mock him and show them what women should do to defenseless and helpless young women. But here you came and denied me that chance. A chance to internally unburden my heart from the guilt of my sister's death. Why just couldn't you trust me? Or hear from me? Tell me why, when we're about to be married, and all you do is to listen to this bitch, and all the numerous lies that she tells you?
Gracious, gracious me. Cow. Did you just refer to me as a bitch?
For lack of a better word. And you listen to this. Oh, tell me. Oh. What was it you're afraid about that girl? You think she's going to take me? Or snatch me away from you? Or seduce me? Tell me what?
Any any of this could have happened.
Oh, shut up! You hypocritical and backstabbing bitch. Why can't I just get a word to describe you?
Callistos, why are you calling her names?
She was only being a friend.
She was not just being a friend. This is not a friend. You know what? The both of you, get out.
Crying over spilled milk.
What did you say?
Annabelle, what did you just say?
I was not talking to you, Carl.
You weren't talking to me?
Yes, I was not talking to you.
Very well then. Look, Janet. You know, I've been meaning to tell you this. I so much hate myself for it. But I just have to tell you. I just have to let you know, okay? You see this girl? This girl is not your friend. This female standing right here is not your friend. Believe me, she's not your friend, okay?
Carl, I know you're really like angry about whatever happened. But what I'm trying to do is try to protect your relationship. You know something? Why can't you just go inside and take some nap?
God punish you!
Baby, she and I have been involved for some time now.
What did you say? Like, I don't understand. I don't get you. What did you say?
I think your man is really tensed up.
No, please, I beg you, Annabelle, stay out of this. Let my man talk to me. I want him to talk to me. Go on, Carl. What are you saying? What did you just say?
I'm sorry, baby. I shouldn't have felt for her. I'm so sorry about it.
Carl, what are you doing? Shut up!
Annabelle, shut up! Carl, go on. I'm hearing you. Like, you two sleeping on the same bed, like dating.
I'm sorry, baby. You know, for months now, she and I have been seeing each other behind your back.
It's not true. Janet, it's not true.
One more word. Annabelle! You, Carl, you two sleeping with each other. How dare you, Carl? How dare you sleep with my best friend behind me? Annabelle, you!
See,
I trusted you, my friend!
Yes,
you.
I'm your friend!
I'm sorry, baby. It's the truth. She's not someone to call a friend at all, I'm serious. Ask Benjamin, he knows it all. Including Aaron. Yes. She's been coming, sleeping around, and I don't know. She wouldn't want us to stop it. I've always told her to let's stop it. She refused, bluntly. She even vowed to destroy us if I go ahead and end the affair. I'm serious.
Let me tell you the truth, you know. Carl here is trying to destroy the relationship we had for each other. You can even ask Ben. I swear to Almighty God, I've never spent more than an hour here. I'm not lying.
Ben, say something. Say something. I don't really understand what is going on here. Say something, Ben.
I'm sorry, Jenny. Carl is right.
Why, bitch? Should have known a date like this would come.
Hi, shit.
See, you guys have to calm down, alright? Calm down. Carl. Baby, please don't do this. Please. You know, leaving me is going to give Annabelle all that she wanted. Please. You need to appreciate the fact that I love you and wanted to be with you. That's why I told you the truth. Please, baby.
Truth?
Yeah.
Did I hear you say truth?
Of course, yes.
Your truth changes nothing. You're a dog and that's it. You hump my best friend's ass. And you want me to give her a second chance. What exactly for? So you could hug my mom's ass too. Never.
Please don't do this.
Don't baby me.
Please.
Leave me alone, don't baby me. I'm leaving right now.
Please don't do this. Please.
leave me alone. Leave me alone now, Carl. You can now go on with my friend.
Please.
I can never, ever have anything to do with you. Never. You're an animal, a beast. That's what you are. Excuse me.
Baby, please. Would you rather prefer I kept it from you? I didn't tell you and we kept doing it behind your back?
No, that's not what's ending this relationship. Sleeping with my best friend is. See, this relationship did not just end today. It actually ended the day you shamelessly allowed yourself to be seduced by her. And hey, we can never build our relationship based on cheats, lies, and deceit. You can never build anything upon nothing and you expect it to stand. Excuse me. Goodbye.
Shidenigo, finally. What are you doing here?
Sorry, sir.
Now, what have you doing here? Will you get out from this place? Get out!